hillside up here. And I already got a deer moving. I can just see the back end of it, and I'm going to try and get some footage of it. Looks like it's working away from me, though. Just bedded down. All right, that'll be something to keep an eye on with it being quiet. So it's bedded right there. I do got a trail coming down here. All right, guys, we're in the stand. Got settled in, got my camera set up, and I got that deer right up over my shoulder, bedded down, couldn't tell what it was, but it makes sense where it's at because the wind's coming from there down to here. That's a hillside up there where it like bluffs off the backside, so he's basically where it's basically bedded down there with its back. It's got the wind coming over the top of that hillside to him, and it's able to watch this whole bottom down here. So it makes a lot of sense why it's bedded right there. Well, let's hope it makes a mistake and comes down this trail to my left. If it does that, it'll be upwind. Hopefully I can get it on camera and get a good shot. Alright guys, just stay with me. Hey guys, so I come in the stand that I was in yesterday that I have seen 9 doe and 2 buck. Of course, they're not legal buck. So I get in here about 3:30. I end up bumping a little doe. She was over here feeding. But the biggest thing I want to talk to you guys about is, you know, we always hear about hunters falling out of their tree stand, getting seriously injured. We talk about tree stand safety. We talk about lifelines and stuff like that. It seems like we always got to wait until it happens to ourselves or somebody real close to us. I want to let you know, we have a good friend that I work with. Great guy. And on his way down off his stand, he ended up falling. He has a broken back. He's in Cleveland right now, undergoing back surgery. Please, gentlemen, make sure you're using your safety harnesses. You know, most of us have family that we want to get back to, and we have family that wants us to get back. So, believe me, doesn't have to cost a whole lot. I just have a real cheap Ameristep. It's like $40. As you see, I got my safety line right there. I ask for your prayers for our friend that is in need right now while he undergoes back surgery from falling out of his tree. You know, it's not just when you get up to the top of the tree that you gotta lock yourself in the tree. We need to get those safety lines, or be using lineman's belt to make sure that we're secure up and down the tree. All right, guys, let's enjoy this hunt. Hopefully that doe comes back, or at least we get one of these does in here. I'm gonna try and get one on camera. It's gonna be first one that gives me a shot opportunity, whether it be a yearling, a year and a half old, or a mature doe. Stick with me, guys. Let's get our first kill with a bow on camera. Self-filming. Have a good night, and remember, be safe out there, guys. Okay, guys. So, just heard a couple gunshots. So, falter. That could have a lot to do with why I may not be seeing anything today. They're up over this ridge from me. So they might bump some deer to me as well, who knows. But it's either some squirrel hunters. That could be rabbit hunters, I guess, small game. Or we got some turkey hunters in here. Maybe that's a totally different direction, so there's going to be a couple people in here. The other ones are up here to my left. That one's straight out in front of me. So, I'm sure they got these deer all boogered up in here. We'll sit tight, see what it brings us. Alright, guys. Hope you can see me here, but finished up tonight. This is October 30th. It's my wife's birthday, and I usually always have good luck on her birthday. I usually at least harvest something. But as you see here, I got the 29th, which was Monday night, and then Tuesday night, the 30th. What a difference just one night made. Got in a little early tonight, ended up bumping a doe out of the area. If I'd have been in there sooner, that was the only deer in that area. So, no public land, had a couple other hunters on the property, and they were kind of like right dead center of the property, and
They shot about 4 or 5 times. So, but hey, some pretty good last couple of days hunting. As you've seen, I had an opportunity. Just as soon as I get my camera turned and get it on them, by the time I start to draw it back, well, you see the buck one time chased her off, and then the second time, as soon as I get ready to draw it back, she steps and goes right behind that tree. So we'll keep at it. And remember, guys, safety harnesses. Make sure you're connected to the time you leave the ground until you get back down. Safety harnesses don't do anything for you on the way up and down if it's not attached to the tree. So prayers and blessings to my buddy Josh. I ask that you pray for him and pray that each and every one of the hunters that you know, you make sure that they're wearing their safety harnesses and let them know that it can happen to anybody at any time. All right, guys, give me some comments. Please like and subscribe. And as always, thank you for watching Boxy's Outdoor Adventures.